We realize because of our ignorance, desires erupt. Because of the desire, there are disturbances. Hope and despair. High and low charyas. Hope and despair. Hope brightens the heart. Despair breaks the heart. Brightens the heart, breaks the heart. Who? That boy. That boy whom I liked very much. No, he has no power to do that. Your hope and despair brightens and breaks hearts. And this has been in all latitudes and all periods in history. It's not only your case. All latitudes, all periods of everywhere, hope and despair. Because of ignorance, the desire, and because of desire, you're tossed between hope and despair. So sometimes your heart expands and brightens up. Sometimes, when we err, when we make a mistake, conscience smites us. And under its whip, hope deserts us. We feel lost. Barabar chhe? Bhul thai, khunche, we start losing hope, faith, and we seem lost. It can be anywhere. I said all latitudes. So the latitude passing from Dharampur also, it can be. If you are choosing to remain ignorant, it can happen even here. Similarly, kashepan na thai. Kashepan nahi. Not in any latitude. May it be Singapore or London or New York or anywhere. No. If your values are. So to encourage this drooping heart and to kindle hope and faith in Him, to set up this weary and distressed and tired and exhausted pilgrim on the path, someone has to help. To awaken us from the deep slumber of metaphysical, or say deep slumber of ignorance. To awaken us from the deep sleep, slumber of ignorance. The task to awaken us falls upon enlightened souls. Kone kahiye apne madad kare? Je suto ite. The task to awaken a foolish person like us, the task has fallen to the enlightened souls. Because of this slumber, because of this ignorance, we have always been oblivious to a higher purpose or to the right purpose. Abhi to higher bolo anati na. Always neglected it or consciously avoided it. But through their aura, through their unparalleled speech, through their personal guidance, the enlightened ones have transformed numerous souls. So, constant cycle of birth and death, transmigration. One who is tired of this transmigration of the soul, the cycles of birth and death, and the one who awakens from it, બે ચીજ થાય. ટુ થિંગ્સ વિલ હેપન. વન, એન્ડ ઓફ ટ્રાન્સમાઇગ્રેશન. હી એન્ડ્સ હિઝ સાયકલ ઓફ બર્થ એન્ડ ડેથ. જન્મ જરા મરણથી મુક્તિ. સેકન્ડ, હી બિકમ્સ ધ લાઇટ હાઉસ ફોર અધર્સ, ઇન્સ્પિરેશન એન્ડ ફોર અધર્સ. ટુ થિંગ્સ વિલ હેપન. ઇટ્સ એકચ્યુઅલી અ ક્રાફ્ટ. અવેકનિંગ ઇઝ અ ક્રાફ્ટ, એન્ડ દેર આર મેની 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 સ્કિલફુલ ક્રાફ્ટ્સમેન, મેની. અમંગ્સ્ટ ધેમ amongst those skillful craftsmen who has awakened himself, put an end to his transmigration, end to his ignorance, and being a beacon of light for others, a source of inspiration and guidance for others, there is a supremely benevolent, a rare divine soul. Say wisdom incarnate, or a creator of a spiritual era, yoga purush. Who is that? Ek bevakat shabd vapri Shrimad Rajchandra. From the first gatha I am going to say param krupalu dev, but from many who, because all are krupalu, all the enlightened ones, all the gurus are krupalu, so I'm specifying Shrimad Rajchandra is one who holds a special everlasting place. In fact, he was one of the adored holy spiritual mentor the world has ever known. So Shrimad Rajchandraji, or whom we fondly call Param Krupalu Dev, his life is constant, ceaseless pursuit of spirituality. Constantly and continuously abiding in himself. His state was without attachment, attachment to external objects, wealth, fame, position, completely detached even to his own body. Constantly and continuously absorbed in his pure self, constantly in the awareness of the self. Any activity, no activity can drag him from there. And his elevated life is reflected in his works, especially his motivational writings, nectar-like writings. Writings, vachan, nectar like amrut, vachanamrut. Filled with spirituality, beneficial to true seekers of self-realization, who really want to attain liberation. So it is Shrimad Rajchandraji, Param Krupalu Dev, was an enlightened soul, number one, enlightened soul. Emna works sabandhi kai pan bolu, but first and foremost and the most important, he was an enlightened soul, guiding many seekers on their spiritual journey. He led them to divine experience. Such was the soul, enlightened and a wonderful guide. Not only guiding, pohchade che. He led them to divine experience. Param Kripa Gurudev preached the essence of the preaching of the jinas. Tirthankar Bhagavanto eje prarupyu enoj sar, essence. He has preached and nothing else. His compassion compelled him to share his spiritual achievements with aspirants of self-realization. His compassion compelled him. Of course, it was his outpouring compassion that he left behind a timeless masterpiece, a legacy for future generations. Atmasiddhi Shastra is a magnum opus, a rare jewel. In the form of a concise scripture. Concise scripture to gain complete clarity regarding the path of self-realization. A concise scripture composed in Gujarati language in a single sitting of 1.5 or 2 hours. Single sitting, imagine. Concise scripture of the essence of the preachings of the jinas at the age of 29 in a single sitting. Let's keep it 2 hours, chalo. Because all satsangs are going to be 2 hours, so let us keep it 2 hours. 2 hours. 1.5 to 2 hours. Single sitting. Beacon of light for aspirants. Every verse, gatha. So compact, yet profound in its content. We'll see that. We'll experience that. Such is the philosophical depth of Atmasiddhi Shastra. It can not only begin seekers on the path on this journey, it will guide them throughout and reward them with great spiritual heights. Sharu karao se. Vachmapan constantly guide ne inspect kartu reshe ane ante pohchadshe. Will reward you with samkit. Self-realization. I feel humanity will be ever grateful to this great enlightened soul for gifting us Shri Atmasiddhi Shastra, such a lucid, logical, scientific way in imparting spiritual knowledge. Generations and generations will be ever grateful. This is the third time I'm going to conduct Jnan Yajnas. Tamara maa baap sathe. And ina baap sathe. Right? I've done it with the Premarpits, I've done with the Sarvarpits, and now with the Uarpits, Jivanarpits. Tired? Oh God, I'm so excited. It's always ever green for me. No words of praise, only tears. To people like me, who are beast-like, ignorant, foolish, unrestrained, materialistic, doubtful, He has gifted Shri Atmasiddhi Shastra to people like us, who would doubt him, who are so materialistic. કે આત્મસિદ્ધિનું કવર કેવું હોવું જોઈએ એટલો મટીરિયલિસ્ટિક. બુક હોય તમારી પાસે, સોનાનું કરવું જોઈએ, ચાંદીનું કરવું જોઈએ, સો મટીરિયલિસ્ટ. ફગેટ અધર થિંગ્સ. બીસ્ટ લાઈક એની વાસના, યુ જસ્ટ સકમ ટુ ઇટ. ઇગ્નોરન્ટ, ફુલિશ, ઇનડિસિપ્લિન, અનરિસ્ટ્રેન્ડ. In Atmasiddhi Shastra, the ideal of self-pursuit, self-absorption, self-realization is emphasized. And that's what we are going to study. So out of all his works, all works are magnificent. And magnificent in the sense, beneficial to all Atmarthis, all true seekers. But amongst literature, most significant is Shri Atmasiddhi Shastra. So if we go back in time, 1890, English calendar, Gujarati, 1946, VS 1946, end of 1946, end, kai yaad aave chhe Rajkathanu, end of V.S. Vikram Samvat, 1946, and the English year, 1890. It was 1890, say, Bhadarva to Aso means October, September, October, November, somewhere. Three worthy seekers by the name Subhag Bhai, Ambalal Bhai, and Laluji Muni. Why am I using these three people? Because they are instrumental in bringing out Shri Atmasiddhi Shastra from Prabhu's heart to us. These three are instrumental. I'll tell you how. So Subhag Bhai of Saila, Ambalal Bhai of Muni of Kanse, Muni to Farta Bhala, Muni. So imagine that year 1890 when these three true seekers realized that the person they have met is a realized soul, enlightened soul. Atmagnani Purusha. They decide to surrender to him and stay in his agna for life. Not a 9-month course, for life. Try to visualize that year. Ketran Patra Jeev ne samjayu ke amne malel purush. આ દુનિયાના છે જ નહીં. આત્મજ્ઞાની પુરુષ, રેર જોયેલ, શોધ્યે મળે નહીં એવા. એન્ડ ધે ડિસાઇડ ટુ સરેન્ડર. સો ભાગભાઈ સરેન્ડર્સ ઇન ધ ફર્સ્ટ મીટિંગ, સાષ્ટાંગ નમન. મેં આજે ત્રણ સાષ્ટાંગ વંદન, દંડવત વંદન કર્યા. મેં કીધું, એક સોભાગભાઈ જેવો, બીજું અંબાલાલભાઈ જેવો, અને ત્રીજું મુનિ જેવો. પ્રભુ મને કોઈ જ્ઞાન નથી જોઈતું, મને ખાલી શુદ્ધ ભક્તિ જોઈએ. મેં અહીંયા લખ્યું પણ છે, શુદ્ધ ભક્તિ. આ જ્ઞાન યજ્ઞ યુ આર સેઈંગ, બટ માય ઓનલી પ્રાર્થના ઇઝ શુદ્ધ ભક્તિ. દેટ્સ વોટ આઈ રિયલાઇઝ. All my shortcomings, all my beast-like instincts, everything can go only, I can get rid of it only by Shuddha Bhakti. I have realized this. Imagine those days, kevu bhakti mai, bhakti nu pur aavyu hase tran hriday ma. They surrender. And they stay in his agna. And very, very beautifully, they earn his rajipo. And when it came to the day of composition of this text, all three were remembered. Sobhagni Vinti, Ambalal no Pratyaksh Lantern, and a Laluji Muni ni birthday. How all three are instrumental and are all woven around Atmasiddhi Shastra. He could have composed his text on Sharad Purnima. What a good day. He chose Aso Vad Ekam. Laluji Muni ne yaad kare. Shu lakhvanu to Sobhag Bhai ni vinti, request. અને કોની સેવાનો ઉપયોગ કરવો? અંબાલાલ. ઇફ યુ સી ધ હોલ પત્ર સાહિત્ય વચનામૃત નેક્ટર લાઈક રાઇટિંગ્સ વચનામૃત પત્ર સાહિત્ય લેટર્સ ઓર આંકને લેટર્સ 956, precisely 955 letters, 245 to Sobhag, Sobhag Bhai, Sadbhagya, around 126, 127, Ambalal Bhai, around 92, all this is Rajkatha revision, 92 Laluji Muni. So it happened that in 1894, according to Vachanamruji, English calendar, V.S. 1950, B.S. Vikram Samvat 1950, English calendar 1894, Chapadno Patra to Laluji Muni, Surat. And then the whole memorizing, then the struggling to memorize Sobhag because of his age. Then his request to Prabhu. Oh, Shrimad Rajchandra turned into Param Krupaludev, and Param Krupaludev turned into Prabhu in hardly 5-10 minutes. So, 1894, according to Vachanamrutji, 1950, Vikram Samvat, Chapadno Patra, 1894, that was sent to Pujya Sobhag Bhai in 1895. He could not memorize it because it was in prose. So, that request. And in 1896, 22nd October, the composition of this Shastra.